Senator Bernie Sanders.
Let me congratulate Troy Price and the Iowa Democratic Party for turning two congressional seats blue in 2018. That is no small feat. The Iowa Democratic Party is on the move, and I look forward to working with you to make sure that in this vitally important battleground state, we take back Iowa in the general election and defeat Trump and defeat him badly. And I will do everything possible to make that happen. And I'm very happy to announce tonight a $20,000 donation from my campaign to the Iowa Democratic Party. Tonight, all of us, no matter what candidate we are supporting, are in agreement that we must defeat the most dangerous president in the history of our country. A man who is a pathological liar, a man who is running the most corrupt administration in the history of our country, a man who does not understand the rule of law or our Constitution, and a man who will soon be impeached. Now, that is what we all agree on. But as friends, and we are friends, let us acknowledge that we have some disagreements. At the end of the day, the Democratic parties of Iowa, of Vermont, and of every state in the country have got to make a fundamental decision. Do we continue the status quo politics, which has enabled the wealthiest people in our country, the largest corporations and their lobbyists, to have extraordinary influence over the economic and political life of this country? No is the right answer. Now, that is where the Republican Party is and has always been. But it, as Democrats, it seems to me that we must chart a very different path. At a time of massive income and wealth inequality, the Democratic Party must become the party of the working class of this country, not of super PACs, not of corporate interests, not of their lobbyists. And in that regard, I am very proud to tell you that our campaign has received more campaign contributions from more people than any candidate in the history of presidential politics up until this point in a campaign. And I want to take this opportunity to thank the teachers, the waiters, the waitresses, the low-paid Walmart employees and Amazon workers and other members of the working class who have supported our campaign so strongly. And now I want to take a moment to quote to you one of the great political leaders of the last century, In 1936, in a famous campaign speech, Franklin Delano Roosevelt said the following as he reflected on his first term in office. And I quote, "We had to struggle with the old enemies of peace, business and financial monopoly, speculation, reckless banking, class antagonism, sectionalism, war profiteering. They had begun to consider the government of the United States as a mere appendage to their own affairs. We know now that government by organized money is just as dangerous as government by organized mob. Never before in all our history have these forces been so united against one candidate as they stand today. They are unanimous in their hate for me, and I welcome their hatred," end quote. What was true in 1936 is perhaps even more true today. When three people own more wealth than the bottom half of America, when in the last 30 years, the top 1% has seen a $21 trillion increase in their wealth, and when many of the largest, most profitable corporations in America do not pay a nickel in federal income tax. Now, I understand that nobody likes to be hated. Not me, not you, not anyone. But the truth is that real change never takes place without struggle. Without having, as Roosevelt told us, the courage to take on a corporate elite whose greed and corruption is destroying the middle class of this country. So tonight I say to you that if I am fortunate enough to accept the nomination of our party in Milwaukee, that convention will not be funded by corporate interests or their lobbyists. That convention and our victory over Donald Trump will be funded by millions of Americans who are sick and tired of status quo politics. But in order to defeat Trump and generate the voter turnout that we need an agenda that speaks to the pain of so many of our working families. And in that regard, let me quote another great historical figure, Nelson Mandela. And this is what Mandela said, profound statement. He said, and I quote, "It always seems impossible until it is done. It always seems impossible until it is done," end quote. Now, the establishment and the moneyed interest always tell us that real change is impossible. Well, let me respectfully disagree. In my view, health care is a human right, not a privilege. And we will pass, whether the insurance companies like it or not, Medicare for all. We will end starvation wages in America, raise the minimum wage to a living wage, $15 an hour, and make it easier for workers to join unions. Every person in our country, regardless of income, is entitled to a quality education, which is why we will have universal pre-K, significantly increased funding for public schools, provide teachers with the income and respect they are due, make public colleges and universities tuition-free, and cancel all student debt in America. And when it comes to whether or not we save our planet, hey, that is not a debatable issue. We will take on the greed of the fossil fuel industry. We will transform our energy system away from fossil fuel to energy efficiency and sustainable energy. And yes, we will pass a Green New Deal. Together, we will reform a broken and racist criminal justice system. We will end the war on drugs. We will legalize marijuana and expunge the records of those who are arrested for possession of marijuana. Together, we will end a broken immigration system, move to comprehensive immigration reform and a path towards citizenship for the 11 million undocumented. Together, we will codify Roe versus Wade into law and make certain that it is the women of this country who have the right to control their own bodies, not politicians. And together, we will stand up to the NRA. We will not be intimidated by the NRA. And I want to thank my good friend Beto O'Rourke for helping to lead the effort to end the horrific level of gun violence we see in this country. Brothers and sisters, good policy is good politics. Now is the time to stand with the working families of our country and end the outrageous level of greed and corruption we see from the corporate elite. Now is the time to create a political movement and a government that works for all of us, not just super PACs and the 1%. Thank you all very much.